Okay, so hi. Today we're going to be going over the Hoover's database and helping to find what all the information that it contains and how that can help you in your courses for economics, for business majors, or for pretty much anything that has to do with studying different companies in the U.S. and internationally. So in order to do that, first you need to navigate to the library's webpage, and you're going to go to click on databases, which is right here, and then the letter H, which then Hoover's will be the second to the bottom, which will bring you to the Hoover's database. And what Hoover's is basically a database that takes all of the different information that is available for publicly traded companies and coordinates it and coalesces it into a much more useful and legible form than a lot of their mandated information from the SEC. You know, it takes the forms that are kind of in legalese and makes it useful, basically. And it's a very, even though it looks relatively straightforward, and for the most part it is, there are a lot of different tips and tricks and ways to have it work a little bit better at getting exactly what you're looking for and to find out the exact information that you need, and a lot more than can really be covered in a 15-minute session. So really the first thing that I want to point you to is the Resource Center, which is the tab right up here. If you click on that, it'll take you to a list of a bunch of different useful areas that you can go to check out. Basically, a bunch of different areas that tell you how best to use the database and how to find information that you're looking for, which is a lot easier once you have an actual assignment and you know exactly what it is that you are trying to find. But yeah, so basically it lets you know a bunch of different ways to make your list and hone things down to what exactly it is that you're looking for. But before you try and learn what it is that, how to improve, you need to learn what you are going to do in the first place. So click on the home, the first tab again, to get back to the main screen. And this is basically going to show you the primary areas that it lets you look up information, and that is, as it shows here, in companies, for people who are working in those companies, and for the various industries. Now you can do a search for everything if you want to get a much more broad result, but typically if you're going to look for something, it would be a bit more specific. So first, to show you an idea of what all the information you can find, a company that we could look into would be, say, Google. In Google, you'll see that it actually has a drop-down menu that you can click on the different companies that Google is involved with. If you feel that that's the one that you want to look for, otherwise click search, and that will give you the actual results, which is 301 different results for Google, which to a large extent, that's because Google being multinational, they have a lot of different legal entities in the different countries that they're working in. So it kind of is a bit of a false positive to tell you that that's the number of companies there. But the one that you're looking for is obviously the one that's based in California and has quite a bit in sales. So you go ahead and click on that, and it'll tell you all the different publicly available information on Google that is out there, but again, in a much more user-friendly and in a much easier to understand form than looking at the SEC documents. Now, the nice thing about it is that it doesn't only give you the information about the company, but it also gives you information about the field and the industry that they're working in, as well as all their competitors and all of the different facts about the company itself. For instance, the number of employees that it has, the number of employees that it has gained over the last year, so if it's growing, if it's shrinking, if they're having potential troubles with staffing sizes or anything like that. It tells you when it was founded. It tells you pretty much all the different information that you could think of, as well as giving you a brief overview of what it is. Typically, the summaries are actually gotten from the company's website itself, so you can take them with a bit of a grain of salt. It's not exactly researched the most thoroughly, but it does tell you at least generally what it is that they do. And if you keep scrolling down, it'll tell you its position in the Fortune 500, if it's listed on the S&P 500 or the Dow Jones, and all the other information that's come in handy for investors and for doing a bunch of different research, as well as all the financial information and the difference between the CEO and the CFO. And again, just a lot of useful information on the basis of publicly available data. And as I said earlier, it also lists the different competitors that it largely has in its market share, so it can show you where they stand relative to others. Which, as you can see, they're doing pretty good in comparison to, say, Yahoo. But that's for if you knew exactly what company you were looking for, it's a lot easier to find it that way. The other interesting factor that you can get is to get the resume or basically as much information as you can about particular individuals. As you look at the People tab, you can type in, again, if you know the person's name, for instance, type in Steve Jobs and click search. Now, obviously, there's more than one Steve Jobs in the world, but the one that we're looking for is the CEO of Apple, which is the first one there. The interesting aspect of the fact that it shows you all the information about people is that it only shows you their publicly available information. You're not going to get, you know, their actual address, their personal cell phone number, anything like that. It does list his phone number, but it's for, you know, the office at Apple, and not even like his particular office. It's pretty much just the general line to the company, because that would be, well, that'd be a bit creepy, to be honest. But also, it would be, you know, a factor that would cause companies to feel less interested in like bulge their information to Hoovers or to other areas if it leads to different kinds of harassment, which that obviously would. But again, it tells you, this allows you to find all the different publicly available information about Mr. Jobs, and it shows the titles that he's held for the last, basically the last decade, and as well as the pay that he's earned, which he had historically made a big deal out of having his salary only be $1 and being paid, you know, just the flat dollar, and also $43 million bonus. So it can help you find all the kind of interesting information about things like that and see a bit behind the scenes what the public faces and what the actual accounting can show in a bunch of different areas. And again, much like a curriculum vitae or a resume, it shows the different jobs that he's held and gives a bit of a brief overview and a summary of just what all that entailed, as well as breaking it down a bit more specifically. You know, being director at Walt Disney is kind of a broad title, but it points out that he was CEO for Pixar for the time that he was there. Or the time that he had oversight in that. It'll also tell you different people who he has worked with, which, again, they're from the Walt Disney Company, but also people who are of the equivalent, being a CEO or being CFO or being president or vice president of different companies that are in the same field or in the same industry as he is, but working in different companies like Microsoft, like Dell or HP.
So again, it's really interesting information you can find, and it's a great way to shed a light on some of the different factors that go into company policy and things like that, because while companies are institutions, they are run by individuals, and there is always a bit of an overplay of what their history is.